Welcome to SSV IIT classes. I am Basha, your math teacher. So we are going to discuss about the analytical geometry, 8th class topics. In previous class, we discussed about the different types of lines and inclination, slope. Now we are finding the perpendicular form of a line or normal form. So generally, for example, I am taking a line which was intersecting the x and y axis at two distinct points, and the line will be L. It was intersecting x axis at A, y axis at B. X, y axis, it is the origin, and I am drawing a perpendicular to the line from origin. So its intersection would be M, means here we have a perpendicular. So let us take the length of perpendicular OM is equal to P, and OM making an inclination with the positive x axis is alpha. Positive x axis is alpha. So that is AOM is equal to alpha. Then to find the coordinates of A and B, then we will find the equation of a line. Let us in triangle AOM. AOM is a right angle triangle at M. So I am drawing here. So M is 90. O A. So here we have 90 degrees. By taking alpha at O, cos alpha is equal to here, cos alpha is equal to adjacent by hypotenuse, means we can choose OM by OA. Already we know OM value P, that is cos alpha is equal to P by OA. Then OA is equal to P by cos alpha or P secant alpha. We can take any one of them. Similarly, in triangle BOM, M is 90 degrees. Similarly, observe, it is a 90 degrees total. So we have AOM is equal to alpha, then BOM is equal to 90 minus alpha. Then by taking the 90 minus alpha value, cos 90 minus alpha is equal to, observe, here we have 90 degrees, so OB is the hypotenuse. By taking same, this is the 90 minus alpha. Cos 90 minus alpha is equal to adjacent by hypotenuse, OM by OB. OM by OB. So cos 90 minus theta, sin theta, it is sin alpha. OM means P by OB. Then OB is equal to P by sin alpha. Or we can write as OB is equal to P cosecant alpha. So we got here OA and OB values. What is mean by OA? OA means the line L is intersecting x axis at A, means we know the point P secant alpha comma 0, A, P secant alpha comma 0. Then B coordinates, OB is equal to P, means the distance OB, 0 comma P cosecant alpha. So these are the x intercept and y intercept. By using the intercept form of a line, we know the condition x by a plus y by b is equal to 1. This is the intercept form of a line. We know x intercept and y intercept. X intercept is P secant alpha, y intercept is P cosecant alpha. By substituting the values, then x by x intercept is P secant alpha, P secant alpha, plus y by y intercept is P cosecant alpha is equal to 1. By taking P LCM and transporting to RHS side, 1 by secant alpha will be x by secant alpha plus y by cosecant alpha is equal to P. Then 1 by secant will be cos, x cos alpha plus y sin alpha is equal to P. This is the perpendicular form of a line. to L. So let us discuss about one more example. Let the perpendicular distance from origin to the line is 6 units and the inclination is 150 degrees. Alpha is equal to 150 degrees. Then find the equation of the normal form of a line. So we know the inclination, then equation of the normal form is x cos alpha plus y sin alpha is equal to p. P is here perpendicular distance, p is equal to 6. Then x cos alpha cos 150 degrees plus y sin alpha 150 degrees is equal to 6. X cos 150 degrees cos 90 plus 60 means second quadrant cos 150 degrees cos 90 plus 60, then second quadrant minus sin 60 means minus root 3 by 2 minus 1 by 2 root 3 by 2 root 3 by 2 and sin 150 sin 150 then sin 90 plus 60 it is second quadrant cos 60 cos 60 is 1 by 2 then the value is cos 150 value minus root 3 by 2 plus y sin 150 value 1 by 2 is equal to 6 by taking 2 LCM minus root 3x plus y is equal to 6 to the 1. So this is the equation of a perpendicular form or normal form of a line which was making 150 degrees inclination and at a distance of 6 units from the origin. In next class we are going to discuss about the perpendicular form of a straight line which is in standard form ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. Thank you.